Linda. Joining us in the rain, I'm Willie Geist, reunited with Natalie Morales. Well, we're going to get some of your singing later.
No.
You and ABBA.
I'm done with the singing.
London, Stockholm, where haven't you been? Hanging with the stars.
Not home enough, apparently.
I guess not, but she's back with us today. Joining us, Abby Huntsman. She's the host of Huff's Post Live.
Great to be here. Welcome back,
Abby. Al is on his Wake Up with Al tour. Speaking of tours, he woke up in College Grove, Tennessee this morning on the Hatcher family farm. We're going to check in with Al in just a minute, but we begin today's Take 3 with the three women freed from a decade of captivity in Cleveland. NBC's Chris and others that some of the neighbors reported seeing things in the backyard and having called police. The Cleveland Police Chief told Savannah, and the mayor has been adamant that they've gone through the records, never got any other calls besides two that were unrelated to this case, to that home.
Well, it's very interesting what neighbors say and what the officials will tell you, so you don't know kind of who to believe here in this situation, but clearly it sounds like there had been some sort of alert in the past about this house.
It's
and what
truly
was going
chilling
on.
And you know, you think, I think they relied on each other to get through it. I mean, they have such a bond. Now they've been together for all this time, and I think they're the ones that are going to have the answers that we're all looking for at the end of the day.
Right.
And you cannot forget the courage that Amanda Berry had to make that break for
it. Oh my goodness.
Knowing after 10 years what the consequences may have been for her and the other women and perhaps her child if she'd been caught trying to escape.
And especially, and just learning some of the details that we just had confirmed, if they had been chained for a large amount of that time as well. Knowing exactly, as you said, the consequences and all of that, and having that just small window of opportunity. Amazing that they're alive and well today.
It's a true testament of hope.
It is. Story's still unfolding. We're sure to get more details about what was happening inside that house today and in the days and weeks to come. We're going to take a big turn now to our Take 2 and check in with Al. He's been down all morning in College Grove, Tennessee, where he's kicking off his Wake Up with Al series. Al, you're looking good down on the farm, I got to tell you.
Yeah, Natalie, in fact, you are one of five cattle, little calves that were born this past winter. There's Natalie, Savannah, Al, Matt, and Lester. Lester, we didn't get to see
Willie?
Earlier.
Wow,
no,
I didn't Willie. Make the cattle
he has
cut.
A Willie snub.
There is no Willie right now, but they tell me with the next crop, there will be a Willie.
Okay. Next spring, we'll have to go back and check out Willie.
I am honored. Let me say, I am honored. We're going to check back in with you in just a minute. We're not going to let Natalie off the hook.
Oh, no.
Yesterday, we saw you at the ABBA Museum. You talked about how much you loved the karaoke experience there.
Oh, it was amazing. Oh, no, again.
Focus on the pop.
Okay.
Let's focus on the pop.
Who knew you had that in you?
I mean,
you could make a career out of it.
Natalie, anyone who watches this show knows Natalie loves to sing. You got passion.
That's all that matters. And especially when it comes to ABBA. And let me tell you, all those fans that were there, the passion that you have. I mean, you don't care if you can't sing. You get on that stage and you become the fifth member of ABBA. And that's what happened.
And I have to say,
I was just counting on the audio people to have, you know, maybe
sweeten it a little bit.
Sweeten it a little, you know, give me a little mic mixer or something to help me out here.
Auto-tune is what we're looking for.
You know,
I will say,
thanks, guys.
You tried very hard to get a reunion of ABBA in that interview, and he just wasn't going to do it, was he?
You know,
he's not going there.
Bjorn, I think he said. I think he said earlier to us. He's like, nobody wants to see geriatrics on stage, and I'm like, people pay good money to see geriatrics on stage.
The Stones are back on tour right now.
I'm like,
still getting it done.
So no ABBA reunion?
No ABBA reunion.
She tried.
Yeah,
she did her best.
You could go on tour.
I think the other band members, I think the other three would be up for it. I think Bjorn is kind of just like, you know what? We had a good time when we did it, and we went out on a high note, and now you've got a great museum to go back. And
the music will live on.
The music always lives on, generation to generation. I mean, especially with Mamma Mia and all of that. So they continue on.
Well, let's move on ourselves to Take 3, and this is the big political story today. Former South Carolina Governor Mark Sanford is an elected official once again, four years after the scandal of his extramarital affair nearly derailed his political career. You remember in June of 2009, he claimed to have been hiking the Appalachian Trail when he left the governor's open congressional seat. Abby, you cover politics every day.
This is one of the most remarkable comeback. I think you put up a picture of Nancy Pelosi, and that scares them.
Well, he talked about his track record in an interview with Matt earlier. I mean, I guess he does. I mean, he's been governor. He was congressman before. So I guess people know what he stands for when it comes to the issues. And I think, by and large, it seems like they've forgiven him for.
But that's the real question.
Past.
Have they forgiven him, or is it just that they'd rather him in office? Because that's the question I keep asking myself. Is it that we've forgiven him and we've forgotten?
I don't think people that's like to believe case. In second chances in mm-hmm. this country too, though. So I think they see, you know, he's now engaged to the mistress. So I think they feel like, you know, he has a new life. And
I thought,
you know,
Anthony Weiner probably slept well last night.
Absolutely.
That he could potentially come back too.
Absolutely. And
I
by
was
the
thinking
way,
the same thing
it was not
morning.
Close. The polls going in had it too close to call. He won by 9 points, which is a big margin there in South Carolina. Yeah. All right, Natalie, how about a check of the other stories?
All right, let's get to
the base coaches because exactly. they're in the line
I'm surprised
of fire
that doesn't happen more often, to be honest.
Yeah, exactly. All right, one more news item of the hour. Let's go back and check in with Mr. Roker once again in College Grove, Tennessee. Sure. As he's taking care of
the sheep
now. Okay.
It's the sheep dance. And even though these are known as the ladies, they've decided to name one Wilhelmina.
Oh. Okay, I'll take that.
Willie.
Okay.
For short. Yes.
That's what we call them around here, too, every now and again.
Yeah, Wilhelmina.
Wilhelmina.
Very nice. It's time for them to eat.
It is time for them.
Inside, getting some cooking lessons in the next half hour from the famous Loveless Cafe. That is good eating.
It's an
ham and jam, baby.
Is it really?
Oh,
you know Tennessee well.
I lived in Nashville. You have to go to Loveless every weekend. You just have to.
What are they known for?
Breakfast, good Southern comfort food.
Oh,
breakfast and lunch.
Now we're talking.
Yep.
All right. We'll check back in, Al, in just a little bit. Coming up next, we're going to show you the happiest seaside towns in America. We'll tell you where they are right after
Thanks,
this.
Abby.
Great job.